Welcome students, welcome class 8 students in our e-learning classes of Barnard Modern School. Students of class 8, today I will discuss question number 6. In this video I will discuss question number 6 of exercise 8.2. Okay, the chapter name is comparing quantities. So previous day I have solved question number 5 and I have discussed a little bit and explained that what discount. Discount means, and one thing I have also discussed that, which is always calculated on selling price. So and I established a formula, that is selling price equal to mark price and minus discount. Mark price minus discount, okay. On that concept we will solve these sums, okay. So discount percentage is given. I am reading the sum that during a sale a shop offered a discount of 10% on the mark price of all items. Okay, so mark price is what is written on the label of any product, that is mark price. Okay, and in that is written as MRP, maximum retail price. You can treat that MRP as mark price. Okay, all items what should customer had to pay for a jeans marked rupees 1400-1450 and two shirts, okay, two shirts marked at rupees 850 each. It means two shirts, one shirt, cost of one shirt is rupees 850, okay, jeans of cost of the jeans, that is rupees 1450. Now question is, what should a customer have to pay? It means we have to calculate the SP, selling price. Okay, so first of all, the relation, and there is no direct relation between cost price and mark price. These are the mark price. Okay, 1450 and 850. These are the mark price, not cost price. Okay, now one thing, friends. So mark price in short MP of jeans, that equal to rupees 1450, and MP of one shirt is rupees 850. So MP of two shirts, that is rupees 850 into 2. So that is rupees 1700. Okay, so total mark price means mark price of jeans as well as mark price of two shirts. Okay, so that is mark price MP of jeans plus MP of two shirts, okay. So MP of jeans, that is 1450 and rupees 1700. So that is, I think, 3120. Rupees 3120. 3120 is the total mark price. Now that shopkeeper have given a discount 10%, and so discount equal to 10%. Okay, and what is the discount amount, exact amount? And I have told you that discount will be calculated, or is always calculated on selling price. So discount amount 10%. 10% of what? 10% of mark price. 10% of mark price. So mark price equal to mark price of 10%. So that is mark price. So mark price is 3120 into 10. Of in multiplication, of is used in our algebra, that is multiplication. 10%, 10 by 100. Okay, so 000. So 312 rupees 312 3150. Okay. Oh, sorry, that is 3150, not 3120. 3150. So mark discount amount is 315. Discount amount is ₹300 is the discount amount. Now question is, what amount should a customer pay for a jeans and for two shirts? Now, so selling price, we have the formula, that is selling price equal to mark price minus discount. That amount, that selling price for the shopkeeper. So what is the mark price? That is rupees 3150 and minus discount amount rupees 315. Okay, that is the, now after subtracting 3150 and 315, rupees 2835. So that customer have to pay, or customer should pay rupees 2835 for that jeans and two shirts. That question is asked in the question number six. So that is selling price of the shopkeeper. Again, I am explaining that. So we know that the formula is equal to mark price minus discount, MP of jeans, that is ₹1450, MP of two shirts, that is ₹1700, total MP, total mark price, that is mark price of jeans plus mark price of two shirts. So ₹1450 plus that is 3150. Now discount 10%, and I said that discount amount is always calculated on selling price. So that is ₹315 is the selling price, and using that formula SP equal to mark price minus discount, that is ₹3150 minus 315, we get to ₹235. So answer is that customer have to pay ₹2835 for jeans and two shirts. Okay. Jeans and two shirts. So students, we have completed question number 6 in this video. Next video, the question number 7, I will discuss that on live class, I hope. And I hope that it is clear to you. If you have any problem regarding these sums or any other sums, you can ask me in e-portal. Thank you. Bye.